إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين.
إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد فإن أصدق الكلام كلام الله تعالى وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واعلموا أن شر الأمور محدثاتها وأن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, continuing with the series of similitudes and examples in the honorable sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah the Almighty says in His book, وَفِي الْأَرْضِ قِطَعٌ مُتَجَاوِرَاتٌ وَجَنَّاتٌ مِنْ أَعْنَابٍ وَنَخْلٌ وَزَرْعٌ وَنَخِيلٌ صِنْوَانٌ وَغَيْرُ صِنْوَانٍ يسقى بماء واحد ونفضل بعضها على بعض في الأكل إن في ذلك لآيات لقوم يعقلون. And within the land are neighboring plots and gardens وجنات من أعناب of grapevines وزرع and crops ونخيل and palm trees يسقى بماء واحد. It is watered with one water. When it rains, it's the same water. ونفضل بعضها على بعض في الأكل. And we make some exceed others in the quality of fruits. إن في ذلك لآيات لقوم يؤمنون. Indeed, in this are signs for those who reason. Palm trees are not all the same. They're not all the same quality. Their fruits are not all the same size or shape. And likewise, is the belief. Believers vary in the level of faith. As Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran, ثُمَّ أَوْرَثْنَا الْكِتَابَ الَّذِينَ اصْطَفَيْنَا مِنْ عِبَادِنَا. Then we caused to inherit the book, the Quran that is, those whom we chose or have chosen from our servants, the Muslim Ummah. فَمِنْهُمْ ظَالِمٌ لِنَفْسِهِ. Amongst them are those who wrong themselves, sinners. وَمِنْهُمْ مُقْتَصِدٌ. Amongst them are those who are moderate, sin and obey. وَمِنْهُمْ سَابِقٌ بِالْخَيْرَاتِ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. And amongst them are those who are foremost in performing good deeds. This is a similitude between a believer and a palm tree. And the date palm tree, the variety, the variation in the fruits and in the fruits with regards to faith. Another point is perseverance, patience. See, a palm tree is a very tough tree. It can handle wind, it can tolerate it, it can tolerate the fluctuation of the climate, the decrease of water, where other trees might be uprooted with the wind. If you decrease water, or if it doesn't rain, it'll dry out and die. But the palm tree is one firm tree, one patient tree. And likewise is the believer. The believer does not give in when struck with disasters. He does not lose hope when afflicted with hardships. A believer practices all categories of patience, persevering patiently in performing the obligations, persevering patiently in refraining from prohibitions, and persevering patiently with regards to the decrees of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Afflictions and hardships and disasters. And these take different forms, as Allah says in the Quran, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. We will surely try you with some fear, hunger, loss of wealth, lives, and fruits. But give glad tidings to those who are patient. What are the qualities of those people? Those who, when afflicted, when struck with a disaster, say, "Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un." To Allah we belong, and to Him we shall return. What's the outcome of this patience? Ulaika, those who persevered patiently, عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة, would have mercy from their Lord and forgiveness, or forgiveness from their Lord and mercy. وَأُولَٰئِكَ, that's number three, هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ, and those are the ones who will be rightly guided. What a reward! As a matter of fact, in another verse, Allah hides the reward as a motivation, number one, and as a sign that this reward is abundant. Saying, subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. The patient will be given their reward without measure, without limit. The abundance of the reward is evident from Allah Azza wa Jalla hiding the quality or the number of what it is. And for this reward that a Muslim hopes for, we must persevere. And I must pause here and talk about an issue that's very crucial and important. Brothers and sisters, we as a Muslim nation now, we as an ummah now, are going through a lot of difficulties. We've been struck with disasters after disasters, afflictions after hardships, and the only resort is to Allah. The suffering of our brothers and sisters in Aleppo and Al-Mosul is beyond description. It's a heartbreaking situation. But as believers who firmly believe in Allah and the might of Allah and the power of Allah, we must trust Allah. We must rely on Allah. Don't give hope. Don't lose hope. Don't give in. Don't lose hope. Allah is there. Muslims existed throughout the history. Islam existed throughout the history. The Qarabatara came and took the black stone for 22 years. But Islam continued to exist after them, after they perished. The Crusade Wars existed and it took a lot of souls. Many rapings happened, but Islam continued to exist with the perseverance of those Muslims. The Tatars, the Mongols, all of this afflicted the Muslim Ummah. But we as an Ummah who trust their Lord, who trust their Creator, who trust His promise, must persevere, must remain firm, must remain steadfast, must remain steadfast. وَإِنَّ جُنْدَنَا لَهُمُ الْغَالِبُونَ. Our soldiers will indeed be the victorious. But we have to remember, وَمَا النَّصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ. Victory is from no other place but from Allah. Put your trust in Allah. Put your trust in Allah. Don't give up hope in Allah as such and because of the difficulties you're going through.
The most important point about perseverance, I must add, is that we die and meet Allah upon faith. See, what they're aiming at is to make us lose our faith. They want us to lose our faith. So our real victory, even if we're shot, is that we die upon faith. We don't give this up for any reason. Massacre, genocide, rape, anything. But we must remain firm on our faith. This should be something that we shouldn't forget at any moment. Because that's their objective. They wish that you become disbelievers. Allah says. The people of Surah Al-Buruj, the people of the Hudud, the people of the trench, when all of them were killed by fire, they were burned, they were victorious. And Allah Azza wa Jalla spoke about them. And history spoke about them, about them as victorious people. Why? Because they did not give in. They did not sacrifice their faith for their lives. They said, death, in return for remaining steadfast on faith, we take it. And they did it. And they won the battle in this dunya, and they won the battle in the hereafter by being of the people of Jannah. The more or the longer a palm tree lives, the firmer it becomes, the stronger it becomes, the more it produces fruits. And likewise, the believer. The Prophet ﷺ, as reported by Imam Tirmidhi and classed as authentic by Sheikh Al-Albani, Abu Bakr said the Prophet ﷺ was asked by a man about the best of people. He said, it is he who lives longer and performs more good deeds. He who lives longer and performs good deeds. And Imam al-Nasa'i May Allah have mercy on it. Reported and was classed as sound by Sheikh Al-Albani, as narrated by Abdullah bin Shaddad. He said, three people from the tribe of Uthra, Banu Uthra, came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam looked at the companions and he said, who would take care of them? Who would host them? Talha radiallahu anhu said, I would. So they stayed for a while with Talha, and then after a while, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam dispatched the troop to fight the battle. One of them went and he was martyred. And then a while later, a period later, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam dispatched another troop, and the second of them went and partook in the fight, and he was martyred for the sake of Allah. And then later in time, that third one died normally on his bed. So Talha said, so I saw a dream. In the dream I saw these three men, these three companions, the two martyrs and the one who died normally, in general. But the one who died normally was more rewarded than the first two martyrs. So I found that strange. So I went to the Prophet and told him the story. And he said, why are you finding this strange? There is nothing better with Allah Azza wa Jal than a believer who lives longer and utters more Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, and Allah. So he got rewarded more. So the long life with the good outcome. It is another aspect of synergy. Life in terms of fruits and good outcomes. Another aspect is that a date palm tree is easily accessible. The benefit of it is very easy to obtain. It's either a short tree, so the fruits are within reach, or a tall tree, but climbing it is much easier. If you've ever seen a date palm tree on the streets, you see how easy it is. It's like a ladder, you know, as compared to the trunks that are straight and flat. So it's easily accessible. And likewise, as a believer, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, may Allah be pleased with it, narrated as reported by a Tirmidhi class was attended by Sheikh Al-Albani. He said that the Prophet said, should I not tell you whom the fire of hell is forbidden to touch? It is forbidden to touch a person who is continuously easily accessible, tender in nature, and easy to deal. Easy to get the fruits from them. The fruits in this sense is the good conduct and behavior and treatment, the good manners of the believer. The fruits of a date palm tree, dates there, are one of the sweetest fruits. And it's very beneficial as well, as we mentioned in a previous book. It's very sweet, and as a matter of fact, they make certain desserts with that. And the Prophet wasallam, since he resembled the believer to the tree, so there must be some sense of resemblance in this sweetness. Yes, there is. It is the sweetness of faith. Ammar ibn Yasir, may Allah be pleased with him, narrating as mentioned by Bukhari and Muslim, that the Prophet said, there are three qualities. Now keep them in mind. There are three qualities. The one who possesses them will taste the sweetness of faith. Number one, that Allah Azza wa Jal and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam are more beloved to them than anyone else, anything else. Number two, that one of them loves his Muslim brother or she loves her Muslim sister for no other reason but for Allah. And number three is that he hates to go back to disbelief, just like one hates to be thrown in the fire. The one who has these three qualities will taste this sweetness of faith in this dunya. And in the hereafter, faith is the tree. Deeds are the fruits, and the sweetness will be the reward. As Imam al-Ghazali, rahmatullahi alayhi, said in commenting on this. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله على إحسانه والشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشأنه. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله الداعي إلى رضوانه. صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وإخوانه. أما بعد. How do you get your fruits from a tall palm tree if you can't climb it? It's a scene that we've probably all seen, kids throwing rocks at the dates so they fall and they eat them or they eat them. This is how a palm tree reacts. It faces evil with kindness. And this is how a believer should be. This is how a true believer is. He doesn't face evil with evil. As Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran, وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. And when the ignorant address them harshly, they say words of peace. In other words, they don't retaliate, they don't answer back with evil things. What a resemblance. And I will conclude with this point, otherwise there are many others. I will conclude this series on the first hadith of similitudes, the similitude between a date palm tree and a believer, with the quality that is known about palm trees, is that its roots don't transgress against other roots. It's within its territory. It doesn't attack other trees, right? And this is how a believer is, or should be. A believer does not pray, he is controlled. He's got the boundaries of Sharia, controlling his behavior, what he says and what he does, the way he conducts himself, the way he looks, the way he behaves, the way he reacts. All of that is controlled. There's a procedure manual for manners in Islam. Right? So a believer does not. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sitting in his room once, and a man from outside his room, say they had only like sheets covering the windows and the doors. So the man looked through the window with his head by removing the curtain and stuck his head inside the room, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was lying down. And he said, had I known that you were going to do this, I would have pulled your eye out with a stick. This is not to say that the Prophet ﷺ was going to do that, but it is just to teach the people, the Muslims, that this privacy is not to be transgressed. If you're on a two-story villa and you're looking from the second floor at a villa that's a one-story villa, you should not be looking at the garden or the yard, because the female of that house might be coming out improperly dressed because she's in her own private property. So you should not transgress with your eyes and your vision. You should lower your gaze, and so on and so forth. The Prophet said, as narrated by Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, reported by Imam al-Bukhari, he said, a true Muslim is he whom Muslims are saved from him with regards to his hand and his tongue. He does not transgress with his tongue against them, and he does not, meaning verbally, and he does not transgress against them or go beyond the limits physically with his hand. These were some points that are worthy of reflection. Similitudes between a palm tree, a late palm tree, and a believer. These are qualities that every believer should be keen on fulfilling and possessing and practicing in his life in order to obtain the high rewards promised as a result of that. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make us true believers, and we ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to enable us to fulfill these qualities and other praiseworthy qualities within ourselves, and to enable us to teach that to our family, our children, our relatives, our classmates and colleagues, our neighbors. Allahumma. And before I conclude, brothers and sisters, a humble request. Please, the least we can do for our brothers and sisters in Aleppo and in the Muslim is to supplicate Allah Azza wa Jalla. Is to supplicate Allah Azza wa Jalla to relieve them. Is to supplicate Allah Azza wa Jalla to support them. Is to supplicate Allah Azza wa Jalla to protect them. To guard their honor. And their blood. And secondly, is to spend from our wealth. Spend from your wealth for the sake of your brothers and sisters. Give. It's not your wealth, it's from Allah. You don't possess it in the sense of owning it. You possess it in the sense of having it in your hand. But that's all because Allah Azza wa Jalla, whenever He spoke about the wealth we have, He said, and spend from the wealth of Allah, the wealth we gave you. So it doesn't belong to me and you. So give to Allah. And don't fear that this will decrease in numbers, because we are taught in Islam, unlike what we have been studying in school and in university, in Islam, 1 minus 1 doesn't equal 0 in Islam. 1 minus 1 equals 700. This is when it's given as charity for the sake of Allah. Because Allah promised 700 multiples and then more to whomever He wishes to come. Allahumma fir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina.